my real niggas only. DJs that play that real live shit. You wanna bounce in your whip with that real live motherfucking cassette. Let's do it.
Hey, what's up everybody? This is Will from Joyful Union Cassette Blog, and this is our third episode of the vlog, where we're gonna be featuring five cassettes that we featured throughout the week on our blog. The first cassette comes to us from Icy Palms Records out of Chicago, Illinois. They focus on a lot of lo-fi, dirty, boom-bap, underground hip-hop. A lot of cool stuff. I like their Instagram account. They have a lot of like video vignettes that, you know, that promotes a lot of their releases, a lot of tracks from upcoming albums and albums that are already released. One of their latest releases is Quicker Than Grenade Casing by Kuartz. Next cassette comes to us from the Dyslexic 6 label. Jason Argonaut's latest cassette, The Cybill Tape. It features, you know, Cybill Shepherd on the cover. You know, one of her more flattering photos, kind of like, I think it's from the 70s, probably look by the look of her hair and style. It looks like it's from the 70s. It's a lot of, you know, boom bap, lo-fi, hip-hop as well.
We'll be right back.
Next cassette is on Seikomart. They're a vaporwave label out of Japan. The cassette is Ryuuji and Friends, Let's Rick Roll Again. Basically, it's a bunch of remixes of Rick Astley songs. Next cassette is on the label Dreamland Syndicate. They're a label out of Warsaw, Poland. When you look at their website, they have a lot of, like, they sell a lot of apparel, a lot of cool t-shirts with cool prints and stuff. And they also release cassettes. Latest releases by Ogdens titled Decay, which is like kind of like noise rock, indie rock, punk, post-punk. And finally, our last cassette comes to us from Track Number Records at a label based in Los Angeles. Latest cassette is by Eris, titled Omniaglyph. Nathaniel Eris is one of the few producers that I know personally that I featured on the blog. We played alongside each other at various shows in Los Angeles. Back when I was when I used to perform as Asymmetrical Head, some of you may know that. I retired that alias a couple years ago, but I may bring it back to do some DJ sets, but obviously in my condition, since I have cancer, I'm not, you know, comfortable enough to go play out in front of a crowd, so can't do it nowadays anyway with the whole social distancing, so I'll try to maybe post a set or two online, you know. It'll probably be on Mixcloud because, you know, I'm not interesting to look at, especially in the setting I'm in right now. It's my room. Anyway, Nathaniel Eris is he's very talented. He's a multi. He has multiple styles of electronic music, from, you know, IDM, ambient. You know, sometimes you hear a lot of juke influences, or even, you know, some type of witch house. Like, I remember, like, back when I played with him, you know, he had a lot of witch house style stuff. You know, obviously he's you know, progressed from that, and as his progression just keeps growing and growing every time I listen to a release of his. And you can tell he puts a lot of effort into a lot of his releases, because, you know, his releases are from, like, you know, they have like 4 year gaps in between each release, and each one is just like, you know, progresses from the last. Well, I hope you enjoyed the show. Check us out next week when we feature more cassettes. Visit us on Instagram. Check out all the other labels and artists that we've featured throughout the couple years that we've been doing this. Show them your support. Show them your love. They need it right now. Until then, see you guys next week.